Happy 80th birthday, Father. You know what? King David said, it's a blessing and good to have brothers dwelling together. And today I see this prophecy is fulfilled here in Crystal Palace. Assyrians, Mexicans, Italians, Americans are dwelling together. And the reason for that is all Father John, because he has a great heart. He has a heart of God that has a place for everybody, regardless to their ethnicity, cultural background, color and language. Father John, it was in Maryville that I understood completely the meaning of unity in diversity. And here we see, even though we are coming from different cultural backgrounds, but we are united. Thank you, Father John, and have many, many, many years. And I wish we will see you always among us, and you are a role model for all of us. And we wish we will have a heart that you have. Thank you, and God bless you, Church.
Wow, what a speech. Okay, John, are you ready for the next one? And who else better than the alumni? I don't know, in your, how many years at Maryville, John? 52 years. So many, many of the alumni, and I know it's a very good representation of you here. So John is counting money, so you learn very good from Father John Smyth too. All yours.
Thank you, Father. First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for being here tonight. This is an awesome thing, which was already stated tonight. I can't even believe that we have Irish here tonight. We got Polish here. We got Assyrians. We got everybody here tonight. And I like to see everybody here at church on Sunday. You know, that would really be good. What I'd like to do for the alumni is, Father, wish you a happy, happy birthday. Father's been awesome to us. I can't even tell you what Father means personally to me, to my family and everything. But to all the alumni that are here, alumni, let's stand up here a little bit. And let's give Father, happy birthday. We love you. And if it wasn't for you, a lot of us wouldn't have a father. So thank you very much. Happy birthday.
Okay, John, and one of the beautiful traditions in one of the great groups is the Italian community. And they are my inspiration to keep working on my Italian. So grazie per la sua presenza. Sei una comunità così brava. E grande, e bella. The Italian community, John.
Thank you, everyone. Father John, on behalf of the Italian community and Santissimo Crocifisso di Cimina, we'd like to say thank you, happy birthday. Thank you for giving us, our community, a home to do our feast. And I've seen a lot of you there this year. Father John was there celebrating. Father Smyth was there celebrating. And he has been there with us as many years as we've been doing the feast at Maryville. So on behalf of the Italian community and Santissimo Crocifisso, thank you, salute, and happy birthday.
And we couldn't miss somebody from Maryville, of course, no? So, Maribel, okay.
Father, great basketball player, great college player, great all-star game in 1957 when I was a young man. And I watched you as you grew older and so forth, and went on and decided not to go to the NBA and so forth. But I want the Maryville people to stand up, please. Maryville people, stand up, please. Are you ready to sing a song? Happy birthday. A one, two, three, four.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Father Smyth. Happy birthday to you.
Yeah! Now, the great, we have somebody else. Carmen, ¿quién va a hablar? Who else?
Jeanette.
She grew up in Maryville. Okay.
My name is Susanna Cloutier, and this is my husband, Jamie. We met 23 years ago at Maryville. We are alumni from there, and we... Oh, sorry. I wanted to say that Father Smyth is more than just somebody who helped us get through our teenage years. He's been more of a father to us than our parents were. And so I wanted to say happy birthday, but also happy Father's Day. And we love you, and we are very honored to be here for your 80th birthday. Thank you for all the wonderful things that you've done for us and for Maryville and for all the kids that you've helped over the years. And it is a great privilege to know you and have you in our lives. Happy birthday, Father.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. You are a father more than anything else. So now I know the great moment. Father John, we want to hear from you. He is the man. So ladies and gentlemen, señores y señores, Father John Smyth, our father.
Thank you, brother. Let's give a great hand to Father Marco, who's done a great job at the shrine, please. Very good. Father Marco. Thank you. Thank you very much. There's no question, as I get older, my priesthood means more to me than it did when I first was ordained. And it's because of people like yourselves that have really shown the way. Now, I wasn't so sure many years ago when I was at Notre Dame University. I wasn't sure basically what I was going to do, and I even was a freshman, I didn't know what I was going to do. But when I came in senior year, and I did get a few offers, or one offer for the pros in NBA, the Atlanta Hawks today, I was really twisted to saying, no, I should do that. Thank God there's a person called the Holy Spirit. I decided not to go that way, and I said, I'm going to go and try the priesthood. Well, all my teammates and everybody else at Notre Dame bet that I would never make it. It came to a point where I said, my heavens, what am I doing? And every year, it just got a little stronger. When I was ordained, I didn't know what I was getting into. They sent me to Maryville. It was an absolute treasure to be working there and putting the lives together for the young men and women. And then I enjoyed every minute, and now I'm 50 years old, and believe me, I wish I was 50. It's pretty nice to be 80. I've never gone to so many parties in my whole life. I wonder what's going to happen if I hit 90. Look at it. Hey. Oh, no, I've got plans to live to be 112. And when I get to be 111, I'm going to renegotiate. But believe it or not, probably one of the best things they did at Maryville, when you're looking back, is Our Lady Guadalupe. I always felt that all the diversity of the languages, the Polish and the Irish, everybody that's here, the Italians, the Mexicans, everybody's here. I always hoped that someday, on the grounds of Maryville, the home of Mary, we would really tie everybody together. It came where I was asked if I would take the shrine of Our Lady Guadalupe. And I have to admit, I didn't know too much about Our Lady Guadalupe. I've never been down to Mexico, but I probably should go down there to see what the shrine was. But I started building a shrine on the grounds of Maryville, and it was an absolute disaster. Every time I put dirt there, it slid down, and I kept getting a digger 2-inch dirt all over the place. And I said, somebody has to know what they're doing. So I reached out and got an Italian, Lee Marchiori of J.S. Adams. Thank God for Lee Marchiori. And he straightened me out in about 2 weeks because I didn't know what I was doing. And he came through and did an awful, a fantastic job. And Lee is now is up in heaven looking down upon us and blessing his family and blessing everything at Maryville. And thank God for the Lady Guadalupe. Thank God, and I hope each and every one of you in this room here feel very, very free to come and worship at the shrine on Sundays. And tomorrow they're having a mass, a class. What kind of a mass is that? I mean Sunday, I'm sorry, Sunday. Sunday where there's going to be a combination. I apologize, I do not know how to speak Spanish. I apologize, or I don't know Italian. I don't know English either. But I'm hanging in there, and there's going to be a mass. You're all welcome to come if you can make it. God bless you. At 11 o'clock. I usually start my 11 o'clock mass at about 11:15. However, this Sunday we're going to start on time at 11 o'clock. Because now, I know some of the Spanish masses are a little longer than mine. I can guarantee you, and I'm Irish, it's going to go very fast. And one person I'd like to introduce and let her stand up and get a great applause, my sister, my younger sister, who was in the hospital just the other day, and she got well enough to come to the party. Fran, stand up, please. Again, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming. Everybody is extremely important, especially when you think about Our Lady Guadalupe and what she means. And if you have a passing attachment to the Blessed Mother, please develop that. It's amazing what she can do. There was a time when I was very confused and going into the priesthood, going playing ball and doing a few other things. I thought I could conquer the world, and I couldn't conquer anything. But that Blessed Mother came into my life, and she dominated and moved me along and kept moving me along. And to this day, she's moving along, and I hope to God I can live to be 100 years old and helping people like yourselves to become closer to Christ. And the Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Guadalupe, is open to each and every one of you. And if you really make her a friend, and I don't just mean a passing acquaintance, I mean a friendship where it really just digs deep into your heart, mind, and soul. And then the Blessed Mother will really help you out. And again, thank you very, very much. And to all the fathers in the audience, happy Father's Day. And I hope your families are blessed and everybody else is blessed. And thank you very much for coming tonight. Thank you.
To you, happy birthday, dear John. Happy birthday to you, and many more. Here he comes.
Sunday to pray with Father John and to celebrate Father's Day with somebody who has been a father for so many people. So gracias, gracias a todos. Thank you for all of you. And before I just let you hit the dance floor, I want to ask Father John to give me his blessing so I can continue this great mission at the Shrine of Our Lady of Guadalupe. So John, if you can please give me your blessing.
May the blessing of Our Lady of Guadalupe and our Lord Jesus Christ come upon each and every one of you, and may you always live according to what our Lord wants, so that you will be fulfilled in mind, filled in heart, and soul with the Blessed Mother and Our Lady of Guadalupe. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, descend upon you all and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. God bless you and thank you for coming.